Hey guys, Jeremy here with Simple Little Life. Welcome to installment number 26 of Viewer's Knives. As always, these are all knives that are made by you guys, the viewers of this channel. It is so cool to see what you guys are doing, so let's get right into it. All right, these first knives we'll look at are sent to me from Phil. He is a 38-year-old knife maker from Saskatchewan, and this one on the very top here, he made from an old file, and he used antler for the handles, as well as the same one in this picture is made from a file as well, and he made that as a small marking tool. Also, he made that chainmail himself. That looks like a lot of work. And then this other knife here, he made from 1084 steel with a cedar handle. I think these are really, really cool looking blades. He's doing everything here with his 4x36 belt sander, and just really, really, really cool work here, Phil. Looks like you're having a lot of fun. Keep it up. Next up, we're going to take a look at this knife from Jethro, and he is from South Africa. This is the third knife that he's made, and he made this thing out of a quarter inch piece of 5160 spring steel. Those bevels were put on using the file jig method, so they're all done by hand. He said he's tried building a 2x72, but he's having some issues with tracking, so Jethro, I hope you get that sorted out. I hope you get it up and running, but in the meantime, to be making knives like this, this looks absolutely fantastic. Keep up the great work, and I thank you for your wonderful email. Next up, we have this knife from Mike, and he is from Staten Island in New York City. He said he's been wanting to get into knife making for a long time, and he's found a lot of inspirations here on YouTube on this channel as well as others, so that is really, really cool to hear. This knife he made is his very first knife, and it is from 1095 steel. He used hardwood scales and steel pins, and he says here that he did everything on his cheapo 1x30 grinder and some hand tools. What a great looking blade. Those bevels look super clean, and this is just absolutely wonderful. Michael, thank you for sharing this with us. Really cool to see you making knives. Keep up the great work. Next up, let's head to the Northern Territory of Australia, and Dan is a 14-year-old knife maker. He's been making knives for about a year and a half, and he's made 9 so far at the time of this email. He's also got a YouTube channel. You can check it out. I'll put a link to it in the description below, Stumping Iron. You can find him on Instagram and his Facebook as well. He's got a really cool video on YouTube about making some ninja stars and stuff, so you should check that out. But these are just really, really great looking blades. It is so cool to see you getting into this, Dan, at a young age, making really cool looking knives like this. I hope you continue to do so and have a lot more fun with it. These blades look really good. Let's head from Australia to Denmark, and Asgar is a 26-year-old. He actually works as an industrial electrician, and he says here in his email that he recently started knife making as a hobby, and he thinks that he's hooked. Asgar, that is really cool to hear. It is so much fun, and this is a really great looking blade. Okay, we're actually going to head back to Australia now, and Michael is a 17-year-old from Bells Beach. He really, really enjoys knife making, and he hopes to turn it into a profitable hobby in the future. This knife here, he did a lot with files, pretty much like tons of work with the files, and he says he went for a really rustic look on the blade, and I think this looks really, really fantastic. He says he's having some struggles with some heat treating. You know what, Michael, that's one of these things that I think everybody has to learn and kind of sort through. I really hope you get it figured out soon, and I thank you so much for your email. Keep up the great work. This knife looks really, really cool. And we're going to head back to Australia again. Ryan is a 36-year-old from Perth, Western Australia, and this is the third knife that he's made. He's made this with D2 tool steel, and he says that the edge is just holding up really, really well, and that's obviously a very critical part about making a knife. This thing looks absolutely fantastic. It looks like a knife that you want to go into the kitchen because of that knife, so really, really nicely done there, Ryan. Also, a couple pictures here. These look like some knives that he's working on, forging those out. These look really, really excellent. So, Ryan, I really appreciate your excellent email. Thank you so much, and I hope you keep having a blast making knives. Tim is a 15-year-old knife maker from Germany, and he sends along his greetings with this picture of this knife. Not a whole lot of information about this knife, but I think it looks really, really great. Tim, thank you so much for sharing this with us. Lucas is from Prague in the Czech Republic, and he sends pictures of this, his very first knife. He says he learned a lot from this channel as well as Walter Searle, so that is really, really cool to hear. And he made this whole knife with a bench grinder and files and sandpaper. To put the finish on the blade here, he actually just wrapped some sandpaper, 80 grit paper, around a drill bit and kind of used it like a rotary tool. That's kind of a really cool technique. The steel he used is N690, and the wood is Babinga. Lucas, thank you for sending this in. I hope this is not your last knife. I hope you keep on making them, because this looks really, really fantastic. Jan is a 33-year-old knife maker from Poland, and this is the very first knife he's made, and this is a really interesting story behind it. The steel that he used, he got from his grandfather, and the tools that he used were from his wife's late grandfather. So this is kind of a combination of the influence of their grandparents, and he puts them together, and he did this knife as a tribute to them. He also made this knife for his wife to take out into the woods to pick mushrooms with, and I think this is a really, really cool looking blade. It is stories like this and seeing how knives like this are made and the influence from our family members and people that have come before us and how they can help us today and then to make this for your wife. John, this is a really, really cool story. Really great knife. Thank you so much for sharing this. Let's head from Poland to Brazil. Vinicius has been watching this channel since 30,000 subscribers, so thank you so much. I really appreciate your ongoing support. And this is the ninth knife that he's made. The steel that he used is 5160, and for the scales, he used a nice brass liners in there with some buffalo horn. Obviously, he's got some brass pins and a copper lanyard tube at the end. I like that jimping, the decorative jimping. Also looks like it serves quite well to give a nice little grip for your thumb. This is a really great looking blade, and thank you so much for your great email. I really do appreciate it. Okay, this next set here is sent to me from Eric, and I actually follow Eric on Instagram. We've had some good dialogues back and forth, and he actually lives very close to where my parents live in Arizona. And next time I go to visit my parents, Eric, we should get together and make something. That'd be a lot of fun. But this knife here, he made with a USA K&F file, this little set. And the thing I really like about file knives is that there's that history, the story behind it that you get as soon as you take a look at the blade. This is really, really nice. I like the American walnut that you use for the scales with the brass pins, and then that matching beer dashi. Very classy, nicely done. Eric, this is a really cool blade. Thank you for sending it in. Also, I'll put a link to Eric's Instagram in the description below. Be sure to go check it out. Michael is a 65-year-old knife maker, and he actually made this knife that was inspired off one of my designs and just wanted to share it with me. This looks really, really great, Michael. I'm glad that seeing some of the stuff that I make can give you ideas for making your own things. Keep up the great work, and thank you for sending this in. Dieter is an 18-year-old knife maker from Germany, and this is only the second knife that he's made. I think this looks really, really cool. He made it from O2 tool steel, and look at all that etching work on the blade. That is absolutely fantastic. Used the multi-layered G10 for the handle, and also made the Kydex sheath himself. Thank you so much for sending this in, Dieter. This looks fantastic. Robert decided to get a little creative here, and he made this little neck knife out of an old chef's knife that was in stainless steel. That is really cool, you know, when you think about it, that, okay, one knife's kind of done its life cycle, turn it into another knife. What a great idea. He used Osaga orange wood here, and then the loop in the scabbard there is brass, and then he used stainless steel pins for the handle of this little knife. Really, really cool little blade. And also, this knife locks into the scabbard with a spring. I'm not entirely sure how he did that, but that sounds really, really cool. Very nicely done, Robert. I like the way you reused and kind of repurposed an old knife to make another cool little knife. Very nicely done. Roger sent some pictures of some knives that he's worked on recently, and he originally started making knives by buying blanks and then kind of finishing them off, putting handles on them and stuff like that. And he's moved from that to making his own with the stock removal method, and is also getting into forging. So that is really, really cool. You know, when you're getting into knife making, start wherever you can, and you can kind of work out from there. Don't let anybody tell you that, oh, you know, you have to do it this way, or you have to forge a blade, or you have to grind your own bevels. You know what? Do what you can with what you can. If it's what is available as a pre-made blank and you want to fit handles to it, let her rip. I think that is a great way to go. You see this progression here. He's made some really nice knives, including this set here that he made for his own wedding. That is really, really cool. And then also you see some forging pictures here of this Persian fighter and then the finished blade. Roger, this is really, really cool to see your work and your progression. It's very inspiring to see you develop your skills and just keep on pushing yourself. So very, very nicely done. All right, these next blades are from a gentleman who really knows how to pick out a great name. Willow Billy Knives. I like that. That's really cool. He's been making knives for about 4 years now, and he does a lot of forging and stuff. He's also got a YouTube channel. I'll put a link to that in the description below. It's called Willow Billy Knives. And this second picture here, this is his first attempt at Damascus. That's a really interesting pattern. And these are just great looking knives. So Willow Billy Knives, thank you for sharing this. I look forward to checking out on YouTube, and keep up the great work. Alright, we're going to wrap up this edition of Viewer's Knives by taking a look at three different blades. These are from Ian, and Ian's dream is to become a full-time knife maker, and that is really, really cool. Ian, I think you're definitely well on your way. These are great looking blades. These first two are a signature style that he calls the Trooper. Just a simple bushcraft hunting type of knife, and I just really, really like the look of it. Very nicely done. And this last one here is a Tanto that he said was inspired by the Tanto that I had made on the channel. He actually used camel bone for the scales for this, and then a brass guard there. Really, really nicely done. Ian, I wish you much success. And also, Ian's got a Facebook page. Check it out. Ian Walker Knife Company on Facebook. I'll put a link to that in the description below. Well, thank you guys so much for sending your knives in. I really do appreciate it. It's an honor to be able to share what you guys are doing and to be inspired myself, and then to share that inspiration with other people. You know what? If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up, and be sure to leave some great comments and feedback for these makers. Let's keep pushing each other on and encouraging each other to keep on making knives, having fun, and learning from each other. If you'd like to have your knife featured on this channel, just email me, jeremy@homesteadknives.com. We will get it featured. And again, thank you guys so much for sharing this. Cheers.